Welcome to FluidSIM video tutorials. The topic of this video is the control of processes in FluidSIM with virtual controls. These are the topics: configuration of EzOPC, binary and analog interfaces from FluidSIM, set FluidSIM ports, configuration of the PLC, preparation of the virtual controller, installation, changes in the PLC program, benefits of PLC training with models in FluidSIM, learning situation. The example project magazine in FluidSIM is to be used for PLC training. Configuration and testing should only be carried out on the PC. The PLC is a virtual Siemens S7-1500 controller, which is simulated on the PC with PLC SIM Advanced. The FluidSIM project is to be set up for direct data exchange with the virtual PLC. The basis for data exchange between the programs is the OPC standard. EzOPC. FluidSIM and the PLC simulation programs are OPC clients that require a server for data exchange. The EzOPC program from Festo Didactic is an OPC server that ensures data exchange. EzOPC can be obtained free of charge from the Festo Didactic homepage. EzOPC must be configured before use. Configuration of EzOPC. The data flow between PLC SIM and FluidSIM is set on the Overview tab. With the tab S7 PLC SIM, the I/O area of the configured controller is set via the button Define I/O Areas. The I/O areas of the controller can be found in the device configuration of the PLC in the TIA portal. Here you could also change the I/O addresses for binary and analog inputs and outputs. In the example, they have been set to the address bytes of the binary I/O at 0 to 3 and the analog I/O at 128 to 137. An analog output or input requires 2 bytes or 1 word. The start address and the number of bytes used for the binary inputs and outputs are entered in EzOPC. In the magazine example, the start address 0 was specified. The controller has 4 binary input and output bytes. When using the analog I/O, their start address and the number of words are also entered. The selected controller has 5 analog inputs and 2 analog outputs. If PLC SIM Advanced is used, the associated checkmark must be set on the S7 PLC SIM tab. With that, everything is set. EzOPC will be closed. Binary and analog interfaces from FluidSIM. Symbols for the transmission of binary and analog signals from and to FluidSIM are available in the component library. FluidSIM has binary inputs specified in the FluidSIM in, and binary outputs bundled in the FluidSIM out symbol. FluidSIM can simulate virtual controls or processes. If FluidSIM is a process, it sends signals from sensors via FluidSIM out and receives signals for actuators via FluidSIM in. Instead of the controller, the FluidSIM in, out symbols will now take on the role of the controller. The sensors, buttons or switches are connected to FluidSIM out so that their signals are sent to the inputs of the PLC. Valve coils, indicator lights, etc. are connected to the PLC outputs via FluidSIM in. Set FluidSIM ports. The connection is set in the properties of the in, out symbols. In the drop-down menu, connect Easy Port via, the OPC connection is selected. The setting of the OPC server, Festo Didactic, EzOPC.2, is already set correctly. The data word must now be set to the correct address using the browse button. FluidSIM outputs are sent to input bytes and FluidSIM inputs receive data from the PLC's output bytes. In the magazine example, only input byte 0 and output byte 0 are used. Input byte 0 is selected for FluidSIM out and confirmed with OK. The FluidSIM out setting is complete and is confirmed with OK. The FluidSIM in port must now be set to the OPC connection and the output byte 0. If both ports are set, communication between FluidSIM and PLC SIM is set up. Save communication settings. If the same ports are also used in other projects, the set port can also be saved in a separate library. A new library entitled Ports is created in the library menu. If you give the library file to the learners, they no longer have to make any settings for communication. The learners only need to drag the symbol of the set port onto the drawing area and connect it to the electrical circuit diagram. Configuration of the PLC. A controller that is supported by PLC SIM or PLC SIM Advanced is selected in the device configuration of the project. Then the address ranges are set in the device overview. The program is developed from the graphset. Two and blocks check the start condition by linking the signals of the start button SF1, the end position BG1 and the workpiece recognition BG3. If the start condition is met, an RS flip-flop is set and the output controls the solenoid valve. If the end position BG2 is reached, a switch on timer starts, which resets the flip-flop when it has expired. The drive MM1 retracts. Before the hardware configuration and program are loaded into the virtual controller, the checkmark, when compiling blocks, support simulation, must be set in the project properties in the protection tab. Preparation of the virtual controller. Start PLC SIM Advance. Click on the drop-down icon, Start Virtual S7150 PLC. A freely selectable name, for example magazine, is entered under instance name. The controller family, for example S71500, is set with PLC family. When you click on Start, the virtual PLC runs in the background. In the TIA portal, you can now right-click on the PLC in the project tree and select Load to Device, Hardware and Software. The TIA portal automatically recognizes the virtual controller and loads the project into the PLC. This is started after the loading process. Installation. In FluidSIM, the simulation is started in the continuous cycle. The observation mode can be activated in the TIA portal. The optical sensor for monitoring the magazine is actuated, signaling the presence of workpieces in the magazine. The sequence is started with the start button SF1. The virtual PLC now controls the virtual model. The state diagram with the position and speed signals of the piston represents the process as a signal time diagram. Changes in the PLC program. Changes in the program or errors have an immediate effect on the simulated process in FluidSIM. If, for example, the time of the timer in the PLC program is increased to 3 seconds, this is directly visible in the simulation. After the change, the program in the controller must be updated. The simulation in FluidSIM does not have to be stopped for this. If SF1 is actuated, the cylinder now remains in the rear end position for 3 seconds. The change in the process over time can be observed very well in the status diagram. Use of PLC training with models in FluidSIM. FluidSIM provides an inexhaustible variety of models for PLC training. In contrast to real models, the signal flow can be made visible in FluidSIM. The PLC training with FluidSIM remains safe. The use of virtual controls enables PLC training independent of any hardware. Thank you for your attention.